in this video a very simple radio receiver that can work between say 600 kilohertz and approximately 4.5 megahertz. It's an absolutely basic radio receiver made with a field effect transistor and an NPN transistor, and this is the schematic. Here is that field effect transistor. It has a coil on its gate, and that is the tank circuit that is tuned to the radio frequency that you want to receive. Of course, on shortwave, this is a very simple solution. In fact, too simple regarding the selectivity, but anyway it works. But for medium wave, this is a quite good solution. The selectivity will be good. And for medium wave you need, of course, another tank circuit, another coil and another parallel capacitor, variable capacitor, compared to shortwave. And it only works up to, say, 4.5 megahertz. I have received a facsimile stations with this setup, with a long wire antenna of, say, 10 meters outside. Anyway, here is the coil, and this is the coil for shortwave. And you can see that I have put in here a ferrite rod. And I want to demonstrate later that you can tune via that ferrite rod by sticking it in and taking it out somewhat. And also with the tuning capacitor, and that's here. From an old simple crystal radio, here under this knob there is a tuning capacitor of, say, I think 10 picofarad up to 100 picofarad. This is the field effect transistor, the BF245. The BF245C is the number that is less sensitive for static charges on the gate. So that means that it cannot be broken down when there is a high static charge on the gate, and that's especially important when you have here a long wire antenna that is hanging outside. In that case, it's a very good idea to make a switch here between the gate and the ground, and when you are ready with radio listening, close that switch so that the gate is shorted to ground and the field effect transistor cannot be damaged. High frequency amplification, low frequency amplification detection is done somewhere in this transistor. Anyway, there is a noise cancelling switch. You switch in that case a small capacitor from the output to ground that limits the noise, and of course don't have too high expectations from such a simple setup. And you have, for instance, to do with no fading correction. There is hand effect, the tuning is critical, but of course this is only when you are interested in shortwave radios and when you make such a circuit and do some experiments with coils, you get a very good insight in how to make a coil for a certain radio frequency band on shortwave. So let's switch all in. The loudspeaker, the signal at the moment, and I will try to tune in somewhat. At first with the variable capacitor, this one, this knob, and also with this rod, this ferrite rod. Let's try that ferrite rod first, and you can immediately see how critical that tuning is.
Okay.
Here you hear all kinds of radio stations passing by. I will switch in now the noise reduction. Well, that's no noise reduction, but it gives a lot of noise anyway. Amplification is too strong. When it is too strong, it starts to oscillate. It has also to do with the way that I made it anyway. So, somewhat less amplification. And again here. It's millimeters. Anyway, it's possible to receive radio stations with it, and at the moment, that's important to tell, the only antenna is this piece of wire here, 30 centimeters approximately, and of course the coil itself receives radio stations. When I disconnect the antenna, we get another situation, and you can still tune in. Here you hear all these radio stations pass. And because this is shortwave, it's very, very critical. All the radio stations are next to each other when I move that ferrite rod. Etc. etc. You set the high frequency amplification here. And the low frequency amplification here. Oscillation. Anyway, try to tune in. And you can immediately see and hear that the whole thing is a quite critical radio circuit anyway. But for medium wave, say between 600 kilohertz and 1.6 megahertz, it works good. I'm absolutely sure I made it in the past. And at first I wanted to make a demo video for this frequency band, 600 kilohertz up to 1.6 megahertz. But in the Netherlands, this whole radio band is dead. Perhaps on other places, on the world, on other continents, etc., etc., the medium wave band is still available. And in that case, you have to make a coil that fits for the medium wave band. And that these coils are here, can be seen here. I will try to make also a coil for the long wave band. Anyway, this could be a good coil for the medium wave. You see the windings here. We'll try to get close. The windings are isolated copper wire, and that isolation gives a natural spacing so that the quality factor of the coil gets higher. That's also here the situation. The plastic isolation here makes that the metal part of the wire inside gets a kind of natural spacing, and that gives a high Q, high quality factor, and a high quality factor means more selectivity. And you could hear that when I move that ferrite rod. This could also be for medium wave a good coil. These windings are in fact not enough. Needs more windings, but you can stick the ferrite rod inside that cardboard tube. And that's necessary, especially for medium wave, to get the maximum energy out of the coil when you receive a certain radio station. That can also be done with the variable capacitor, but anyway, you can tune in to a more sharp signal, radio signal. This is also a typical medium wave coil. This also, of course, you have to stick in here in this cardboard roll the ferrite rod to get to the right frequency band. It has everything to do with inductance, etc. So the inductance is going up very strong when you put in a ferrite rod, and this is a typical long wave coil as far as I could see. So that are the possibilities of this radio. When you connect an outside antenna, you need here a capacitor of 14 picofarads. That's necessary. That makes that the coil is decoupled enough to keep its good resonance frequency, to keep its good sharpness, to tune in to a certain radio station. When you make here, for instance, a wire of 10 meters, the properties of the coil, the quality factor, etc., etc., are completely ruined by that long antenna. It brings the frequency down because the antenna is also a coil. So we have here a coil on which there is hanging another piece of wire that has inductance, that has capacitance, and that brings the good quality of your coil down. So 14 picofarad, I've tested that out many, many times, is a good value to connect a long wire antenna. And that's also here. I couldn't find a 14 picofarad, so I've taken a 18 picofarad here. But anyway, 14 is the best value. Noise reduction, amplification, high frequency amplification. Well, there's not so much more to tell. It goes maximum to 4.5 mega cycles. And you could hear that when you are working on shortwave, all the radio stations are kind of close together when you turn that knob. Of course, when you have a smaller variable capacitor, it's better to discriminate, could be better to discriminate all the different radio stations. Anyway. It's fun. So you can hear that it is quite difficult to tune in, but anyway, that's the reason is that this is shortwave, but for medium wave it will be good. And also when you use this, for instance, as a kind of first active antenna stage for a super heterodyne radio, that's also possible. And in that case, use here, for instance, a BF transistor. When you want to go to higher frequencies, higher than 9 MHz, because this transistor, only the BC547, works maximum to 9 MHz, up to 9 MHz. Anyway, always fun to see, to try to get good results with such a simple setup.